Hey, all you bad kids, just here to give a shout out and to let you know, if you're looking for statues, busts, premium format figures, and anything in between, make sure you go to SideshowToy.com. It's the only place to go. For all you 1/6 scale collectible figure collectors out there, Alter Ego Comics has everything you need. They accept PayPal, they have pre-orders, and they got the lowest prices on the internet. And for all you action figure fans, yeah, you know who I'm talking about. Big Bad Toy Store is the only place to go. From Transformers to Batman and everything else under the sun. BigBadToyStore.com.
I was born, the nurses all gathered round, and they gazed in wide wonder at the joy they had found. The head nurse spoke up, said, "Leave this one alone." She could tell right away that I was bad to the bone.
Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the very first Bad Kid Unboxing. Today we're going to be going over Sideshow Collectibles 1/6 scale Nathan Drake collectible figure from Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception. So we'll go ahead and take a look at the box after we get it out of the brown shipper. As you see, it's got this nice brown and tan background with gold writing at the top. It's got the PlayStation logo and then PlayStation written next to it, the Naughty Dog with their infamous paw, and then up top they have a silver sticker, official licensed by PlayStation. Then beneath it, Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake. It's got a gold and black trim around the entire front of the box. And down at the bottom, Sideshow exclusive sticker, 6th scale. Soon as we turn the box to the side, we get another Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake printed along with the golden trim. Excuse me. On the back, we have yet another Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake printed. And when we get to the side of the box, it also has another Uncharted 3, Drake's Deception, Nathan Drake. So at least they're labeling it properly. I don't think anybody will get confused what's in the box. So once we open it up, as you can see, there is the tissue paper sleeve covering the plastic window of the figure and all of his accessories. On the left side of the actual cardboard flap, we have a nice golden emblem. Kind of fits the style of the game and figure. It says Sir Francis Drake, Sic Parvis Magna. If any of you guys know what this means, please leave me a comment. I'm very curious to find out what it's actually saying or its meaning. Moving on to the plastic sleeve, it shows Nathan Drake looking absolutely amazing with all of his accessories, his guns, his watches, and all of the goodies that we will get to in a moment. As you can see, just from a quick glance, Sideshow has done an absolutely phenomenal job with representing and remaking the video game figure. I always think it's extremely hard to take a computer-generated image and bringing it into a real-life three-dimensional figure. So kudos on that, Sideshow. After you remove the first plastic sleeve with Nathan Drake, you get another plastic container containing his stand, a few spare hands, the map, and the exclusive big ol' spider. I'm a fan that they use the actual video game cover art for the background. As you see, it is the burning cargo plane that has landed or crash landed in the desert. I thought that was a nice little touch, bringing elements of the game into the figure and the box itself. When we move on to what's actually in the box, we will get to the four hands. As you can see there, he comes with two relaxed palms. Well, these are actually more gun-gripping hands, I guess you could say. He comes with a left and a right great paint application, nice flesh skin tones. You can see the detail in the mold. He's got veins popping out. Each hand does come with its own wrist peg. That's one thing I think Sideshow does better than pretty much any other company. They provide you wrist pegs for all the additional hands. I love that about them. And then he comes with a left gripping hand, semi-fisted. Same great paint application and detail. Can't go wrong. As you can see, you can actually see the individual veins. I like that. And then another left semi-gripping or pistol holding hand. I guess you can just mix and match and figure out which hand fits what accessory best in your opinion and apply it accordingly. A nice little close-up, same great paint application. As you see, the flesh tones and the little wrinkles even under on the palm, I think that is that nice little extra mile that they've gone. They could have just made it a smooth tan colored surface, but they actually put the actual wrinkles of the skin in. Now this is a exclusive accessory only. For those of you who have ordered or are thinking about ordering, the exclusive comes with this gigantic spider from the video game. It's one of the so-called enemies. As you can see, they've done a great paint job on it, giving it a gray and or a black base with gray speckled or spots along the underbelly and top part of the body. As you can see, he's got a green head and mandibles or mouth. You can even look and see the individual eyeballs. He's got some blue and teal on his joints for his legs. Great job on the spider. Good paint application. He comes with his standard, or not standard, but he wears this in almost every video game, his leather wristwatch. I think the mold and the detail that they've put in this is absolutely so cool. They've used the big leather strap and then topped with a thinner leather strap that actually holds the watch and the little silver buckle. Even the watch face, they've painted the hours and the hands of the watch separately so it pops out. He comes with a 9mm pistol, silver base with a black handle. It is not articulated, but the detail and the paint application make up for it. Great little gun. He also comes with a AK-47 with an articulated stock. As you can see, it folds back and forth. It's got good wood grain painting on it. The clip is retractable. That little extra mile and painted the bullet casing gold so it stands out and looks like it's actually completely loaded. It slides in and out quite easily. The mold of it's quite nice. It's got the nice ridges. Looking like, I guess, a real life AK-47 stock. I'm not a huge gun buff, so, but it looks pretty much exactly like the gun did in the game, so I think they nailed it if that's what they were going for. They painted the wood with lights and dark browns to make it actually look like grain on the wood. They have a silver slide. Moving on, he comes with two chest strapped satchels. One that actually holds bullets. As you can see, they've painted the individual bullets with the red tips and gold casing. They have the leather patches with the buttons. Now they do not unbutton, but it's still all in all a very nice accessory. It comes with a strap and buckle to attach it to the figure. So you can just wrap it around his chest, put it through the buckle, and voila. Then he comes with a standard just satcheled chest strap. Nothing sticking out. Just normal leather pouches and stuff with little metal buttons. They do not open up, so please do not try to. I don't want you to mess up any of your accessories. But it is real leather. They have added little cuts into it so it bends and wraps around the figure quite nicely. It's not looking like a hard piece of plastic or rubber that kind of doesn't move or bend to the figure's actual shape. So that's done all in leather. Then he has a little map of the area in the game. As you can tell, it's extremely detailed with the geography locations listed, The little ship there, even the little mountain terrains throughout each area. Moving on to the back. Now, in the video game, Nathan Drake had a little diary, and when you came to a certain puzzle in the game, you would check the diary and you would come to certain images that looked pretty much exactly like this, and it would help you and give you clues on how to solve the puzzle. I thought it was nice that they added it. It would have been nice for them to actually add the diary, but for them to still add this and the map with all the details and the writing, that's actually quite nice and a little throwback to the people who have actually played the games. A nice little nod to them. He comes with a black plastic base that has Uncharted 3 Drake's Deception written on it. It's kind of thick, so it's not like the normal thinner 1/6 scale stands. It's got some width to it. So it's got who it's been produced by, Naughty Dog and Sideshow Limited, and licensed by all them and manufactured. Comes with the adjustable cradle, not the waist grip, as you can see right there. More and more, it's starting to become more and more standard stuff with some of our 6 scale figures. We're just expecting it. Alright, so let's get some in-depth look at this guy. As you can see, and I've always said this, it's hard, or in my opinion, I think it's hard to probably bring a video game to an actual 3D figure, but I think they nailed the head sculpt. As you can see, the detail on the little paint application for his 5 o'clock shadow, his hair, looks like actual individual hairs, his eyebrows. Now, one quick thing I'm going to say, his eyes, the white around his eyes, are quite red. Now, I'm not speculating on as to why. Let's just say maybe he got sand in them, but I thought that was a little odd. He has this bandana that's got frayed and teared edges, like he's actually been wearing it and been trudging through the outdoors and wilderness. It's got some wear and tear and dirt on the outfit. I think that's absolutely wonderful how they've done the wearing and little paint app on that. For any of you who have played the games, you should know the significance of the necklace and the ring. For any of you watching this, if you remember what the ring is, leave a comment below. I'd like to see if any of you actually remember what it's from in the game. He comes with two arm leather straps, the satchel and the pistol holster. He comes with a very nice detailed gold belt buckle with a nice little horseshoe emblem on it, attached to yet another leather belt. He comes with almost like a, trying to find the right word, I guess you could say it's just cotton, a cotton shirt that's got the wear and tear and weathering on it to make it look like he's been sweating and doing all of his Uncharted climbing activities through it. He's got olive green pants. Now, bear with me, I know this is not where the bandoliers and all them go. For some reason, I had a brain fart, and I just couldn't figure out where they went. So I was trying to put them on his leg, his waist. I was trying everything and anything because it doesn't come with an instruction manual. And I'm probably going to sound like a complete idiot, but that's what I tried to do. So just for all of you guys watching this, it should go around a shoulder, across the chest, under the arm, and back around the back. That's the proper way to apply them. Great detail in stitching and sewing work on the pants. They are tight-fitting pants, and the legs themselves. You know how with some figures you get the real skinny legs and baggy pants, and it makes the pants look even baggier? Well, he's got nice, thicker legs, so the pants look nicely form-fitting. He's got the tan khaki boots. I guess they're similar to, I guess you would call them Tim's. The weathering on them as well and the paint application look like he's been wearing them and running through the mud. It's got the cracks, and I like that. It's even got the little cracks in them, like, because if you ever gotten a pair of Tim's muddy or wet, eventually when they age, they start to crack. Well, I like how they actually added that little touch. It's going that little extra mile, and I appreciate that. So that's a nice little in-depth look at the guy. Let me know what you think in the comments below, if you think they nailed the head sculpt or if you think they didn't. I think they did a decent job with it, considering. Sideshow always does a good job with most of their figures. For the articulation, he can rotate 360, but actually, you don't really have to worry about it, because with this, he has the cloth bandana there, so you don't have to worry about any of the paint coming off. He can do side to side, up and down. For the arms, he does have
a great range of motion for the arms. They can go up and down, side to side. They can go pretty far up. They can almost do a complete 360, but the shirt begins to bunch up, as you can see there. So you want to just not go all the way. I don't want you to rip the shirt or break the figure. So just be careful when you try to do the 360 motions. But all in out, very good range of elbow joint or shoulder joint motion. For the elbow joint, I'm not sure if that's 2 points, but you can get a decent bend out of the elbow. I tried putting him in several different poses, and I didn't really have a problem no matter what I was trying to do. The hand is on a ball joint, so you can get the 360, the swivel in and out. Excuse me. Pretty much any range of motion you would want to do with the hand. As for the waist, he's quite maneuverable in the waist. You can go do the ab crunch. You can go side to side. And you can go back and forth with a twisting action. So you can get him into all kind of leaning, bending over, bending backwards kind of poses. As for his legs, I thought due to the fact that they were tighter fitting pants that it would be a problem, but I was wrong. There is a great deal of motion to be had with the legs. You can bend them, not into a complete split, but you can get it up there. He can bend pretty, or let's face it, he can probably bend further than I can. So he has a ball joint at the upper thigh, so you can get the nice twist motion going. He doesn't have a cut joint, but his knees do bend at 2 points, as you can see. There's really no restrictions or hindering from the pants whatsoever, so any position you're trying to get him in, you won't have a problem doing it whatsoever. As for the boots, he has a ball joint on the foot as well, so you got the little side-to-side 360 and the angled up and down and tilting in and out. So for yet another great figure from Sideshow, there is a ton of articulation in this guy, so I don't think any of you will have any problems posing him in the way that you want him to be posed in. So thanks for stopping by, ladies and gentlemen, for the first Bad Kid unboxing. There are a ton more coming. Please stay tuned, click the subscribe, check my new videos. I'm always updating it, always posting. Got several updates and news, discussions, contests, and giveaways. 1,000 subscriber giveaway is going to be the first huge giveaway, huge prize. So remember to click that subscribe. Here's another quick glance at the figure. I want to thank Sideshow Collectibles for making such a great figure. This is the 1/6 scale Uncharted Nathan Drake collectible figure. For all those of you who are on the fence about getting them, hit up SideshowToy.com and pick them up.